Well, just what exactly is antimicrobial resistance? The key thing to remember, it's not related to individual behaviour or resistance developing in humans themselves. The resistance actually develops in the bugs themselves.
It's not quite 100 years since Professor Alexander Fleming made his serendipitous discovery that a spot of mould in an agar plate prevented the growth of bacteria. And yet, in the ensuing century, that discovery has saved countless lives and added decades to our life expectancy. And yet, here we are, less than 100 years later, at risk of losing it all, of returning to a world that predates antimicrobials because of their ineffectiveness in treating common conditions.
So this isn't just a problem in Aotearoa New Zealand, it's a global problem. It's been highlighted as one of the top 10 global threats by the World Health Organization, and there's huge evidence syntheses out there from places like the World Bank, really supporting that this is a major global issue.
So what can we do about it? Well, learning about antimicrobial resistance and talking to our friends and family about what it is really important. If your doctor prescribes you antibiotics, ask them, are they following the latest guidelines? If they don't prescribe antibiotics, well, trust them, you don't need them. Remember, antibiotics don't work against viruses.
So our doctors and nurses and other prescribers in New Zealand are very well aware of the need to use antibiotics wisely.
We need to handle these antimicrobials with care.